Hey, I just wanted to do a little update. It's early morning and I fell asleep early night last night and then wake up in the middle of the night and now I'm going back to bed, so it's still yesterday in my head. I always sleep weird hours. I said yesterday I wasn't feeling that well. It's really hard staying positive all the time when you're sick. And I'm not, I mean, now I'm pretty, my pain levels are really low compared to what I was used to. But now if I get any pain, it's like, oh, I'm in pain, like, because I'm used to having pain free now. My energy is starting to come, but I can't walk around or do things like I can do, you know, make myself a milkshake or something like that. Anyway, that was getting to me because I keep waking up in the middle of the night to have milkshakes. I'm like, this is crazy. Like, how can this be good for me? So I looked up all the health benefits again. And I also went on a site that was about curing cancer on YouTube, Facebook. And I was reading all the things that they're using. It's different. Cancer's different. I've got polycystic kidney disease and I'm at end stage. I've been at end stage for years. So, I'm in fail. I've been in renal failure for a long time. 5 years. So, 4 years, something like that. 5 years. Yeah, 5.5 years. So, well, they told me I had 12 months to live 5.5 years ago. So, yeah. But anyway, so I looked up what they were doing on there, and they were talking about vitamin D and vitamin K and all this stuff that why it's good for you. And also, I have bicarb soda tablets. I don't know if I mentioned them, but I have. I think right at the start, I don't mention them as a drug because they're not, but I probably should. But I have those as well, and they were talking about them too. But it's a different disease, and no one's done what I'm doing. I'm trying to regrow kidneys. They're trying to get rid of a tumor, but we're both detoxing and trying to grow, get rid of bad cells and grow healthy cells. So some of it corresponds. And then I went back and I looked at the ingredients in my milkshake. And the only thing that's been worrying me is the potassium. And I know that if I start worrying about it, it's gonna be a problem because I'm working with power of the mind. So if I think it's a problem, it'll be a problem. So I've got to stop worrying about it. But how do I stop worrying about it? Because it becomes a vicious circle of I'm worrying about it. Oh no, if I worry about it, then it'll make it happen. Oh no, but I am worrying about it, so it's making it happen. Then you got to get yourself out of that circle. And so it happens all the time. They tell me, like, it's really hard when I get the test from the doctors and they say, you're dying. Or this is, you got this, you got that. It's like, I don't want to hear what they've got to say because they don't know what I'm doing and they can't test. I've asked them, can you test for what I'm doing? And they said, no, because the government only allows them to test for certain things and their tests don't correlate with what I'm doing. It doesn't help. It makes it harder. It's like they're killing me. Anyway, or helping. So, I read some articles and there's some people on there that had healed themselves and some people that had cured themselves. That was good reading some true stories and also realizing that the ingredients in my milkshakes are superfoods and doing what I need. They're giving me the things I need at the moment. So I need to stop worrying. So I've just programmed my water. Every time I drink water, it gets rid of excess potassium. So that's what it does. And I just believe it and it will work because it will. And all the things in my house are magic anyway, so it'll definitely work. Okay, that's probably going to be my video for today. I don't know, I might join, have put another one on the end. When I wake up, and tell you how I'm feeling for the day. But yeah, I just wanted to talk about that because it's not all joy, joy, happy, joy, and yeah, I'm gonna do it and so positive all the time. It's a constant battle with my own head, and any negativity at all affects me. And it takes days, sometimes weeks, to get over it. And then I go into a hole thinking, oh, how I'm gonna die because I'm thinking that, and I just go into fear. So it's really hard to pull myself out of it. But groups like that, and talking to people, and being around positivity, and people that have done it before, and stories, or done similar things, even if no one's done what I'm doing before. Other people have done other things that are similar to what I'm doing. So I take inspiration from them and keep walking my own path because, as strange as it may be, it's tasty. I'm enjoying it. It sits really well with my belief structure. It fits perfectly with everything I believe, and it's almost like I'm afraid to feel good. I'm not afraid to feel good, but it's like I feel like I'm supposed to be. Like, I've even been told, don't let people see how happy you are because they'll try and take it away from you. It makes you vulnerable. Well, they don't realize how tough I am. You gotta be pretty tough to be this. I kept asking the universe, what is it? Why, if what doesn't kill you makes you stronger, how fucking strong do I have to be? And the answer I got was strong enough to be soft. So that's what I'm trying to be, is soft but strong. I think I've said that before. But yeah. Anyway, I'm rambling. That's what I tend to do on here. It's a vlog, that's why. Vlogs are for rambling. So I could do like a proper introduction and tell you what I was going to talk about, and then do a middle and talk about it, and then sum it all up at the end. That would be like what normal people do. Anyway, I hope you're having a wonderful day, and I hope you're listening to your body to see what you want, because I believe that what we truly want, if we're in line with divine love, is our destiny. Our true heart's desire is our destiny, and what we truly want is okay. We're allowed to have that. In fact, we should, because we are God, ultimately, of ourselves, if you want to see it that way, because what else could we be? Anyway, that's just my take on it. People say don't say God. I don't believe in that God thing, but I don't know what other word to use. Love, universe. We're all one big thing or something. I don't know what it is. I don't know. I know a lot, but that's why I know I don't know. Anyway, I am going and I'll finish this off with my traditional ending. It's become my ending now. My living wish is to meet the rapper Eminem. And I've written a few raps myself. Why not? Why not? I'm angry sometimes a lot. It's a good way to express yourself. And I appreciate that the opportunity to be able to just do it. And yeah, fun. Yeah, anyway, please subscribe if you want to hear about if I live or die. Ha ha. Bye.